Hi, I'm Joanne Barbie from Australia. I'm here with the makers of Pan Pastel in Pennsylvania, and I'm going to show you how I start and finish off a picture of an owl in Pan Pastel. Okay, I'm just going to work on this owl reference. It's just going to be my guide to tell me where things are going to go. It's not exactly copying it, it's just a bit of a guide. I'm going to be looking for all the colours underneath first so that I can fluff the feathers over the top and get to the lighter colours on my way. So I'm just going to start usually with a block. So looking at the beak, I'm going to start with the beak and make sure that that's in the right place first, and then I'm going to find my way from there. I don't hold back, I just go for it. Whatever depth that I can see, I'm only looking for tone, so the darkness underneath the feathers. And I'm looking for shapes, and I move from one shape of colour to the next, to the next. So I know that the beak comes right out under the eye and the feathers are going to fluff over the top, so I'm going to come quite a long way out. And I'm just using this tool, just blocking it in. I'm not really worrying about the marks that I'm making yet. Just get a sense of that beak in there. Even though that's light, I'm just trying to find the form straight away so I know that the beak is shaped in a round sort of motion. So I want to be doing that right from the start so that I have the 3D sort of look nearly straight away. Okay, so once I've put in my deep dark bit here, I'm going to look for this next block of colour here. And I don't worry if it's the exact colour. I find I mix them, and it doesn't matter if I get a little bit on the pans. I'm just finding my way over. I don't ever measure out where the eyes are going to go first. I just find where I'm just moving. Do I have enough room here to the next colour, and I move along. And that way I get my colour map down. There's a little bit of purple underneath here that I'm finding, purpley blue. And then once I find it in one spot, I try and find it in other spots as well. And I just clean it with a little bit of paper towel, and the colour will, until the colour is off. And I really only do that if I'm going too far in a tone. So I really want to just be in it. And I don't want anything to hold me back. And the Pan Pastel allows me to do that. Just go for it. It's just mark making. And these let me have little feathery movements. So I'm getting the shape of his head. And you can use the paper to your advantage as well. I've started with this grey, so I have a little bit of depth straight away. It's just really mark making and movement and depth to start with. Still just finding the differences in between. And I turn the sponge around, I'm trying to find little angles or flatness flat feathers. The best thing about pen pastel is I can jump straight into the colour. I don't have to do a preliminary drawing. I can just move it around and find my way. And once I have my base layer down, I'm going to erase it a little bit just to neaten it up a little bit. I work in very thin layers to start with, moving my way up to feeling more confident of where the colour's going to go. Just again putting the depth in here. Not too worried about the shape of the eye yet. Don't really worry about the size too much. As long as I know that things are going to fit, I'll worry about that later. Just change tools. I'll use this one. I do like this one because I can load it up with different colours on every angle. Just getting a sense of form. And everyone has a different mark, so if your mark isn't the same as mine, that's fine. It's just the way that I make my mark. These tools are to be played with, and different angles, different markings. There's no set way on how to do it. Again, just measuring. I know that an eye would be round, so I'm always, every movement I make is always in the direction of what it would be in life. Always a bit darker than what it is. And I know the complementary colours, so I'm going to play up the blues and purples and the orange, which complement each other. So the way that I'm moving along, I know I have this much of this, this much of this, this much of this, and it's my guide to get me to the next spot. And it might not be exactly in the right spot yet, but this is my map. And because I'm using these thin layers, I can experiment on the page. I can find out what colours I want to use. I've decided I don't really want this really bright yellow. I want it more of an orangey to marry in with this. So I can just go straight over the top of it. So no mistakes. It's just all finding our way. Another thing, as I was saying about the no mistakes thing about pen pastel, is before, when I used to use soft pastel sticks, just soft pastel sticks, I used to draw up a drawing of a beautiful charcoal drawing underneath where my pastel sticks had to go, And then if it wasn't perfect or I couldn't find it, and because it was in the black and white, I sometimes didn't even get to the fun, colourful part. So Pan Pastel allows me to jump straight into the colour, straight into the fun stuff. And that's the way I see. I see in blocks of colour. I don't see in lines. It's immediate. Using the edge of the sponge too gives you a finer point. And I put quite a lot of colour on it, so it might look a bit leery and brash at this stage, but I'm not concerned with that because I can dull it down later. Again, the black will just blend with the other colours for my depth. So I might put a bit of black down and then just blend another colour over the top so I can get my dark areas. So don't be afraid to put black down. Just moving from one to the other, making sure that I have the beak coming about here with the pupils coming down. To move his eye over, so if you don't get it in the right spot straight away, you can just go straight over the top. Just taking a moment to stand back and have a look and just make sure that I'm on the right track. I'm getting there and I'm just moving my way over. The best thing too about Pan Pastels, I have three small children and it's being a dry medium. I can step away for a second. I don't have to worry about paint drying. I can just have it all set up and ready to come back and have a break whenever I need. This layer, I'm quite heavy-handed with the pastel. I'm pushing it in, and as you get to know the tools, you know how much you can put them in or whether you want a feathered type later on. So I'm not too worried about how it's being applied at this stage. Just find my way up and I again with the reference image, it's just a guide. I always fluff my feathers a little bit more than what they are in the photos. I play on the eyes. They might be just a little bit bigger than what they are in real life, just because that's where I want my focal point to be. Try and work on a picture as a whole. So if I'm putting a bit of colour in one point, I try and put a little bit of it in other spots as well. Just to marry everything together. And I blend on the paper, but I also get a bit of one from one pan and I'll get a little bit from another sometimes. Just mixing my colours. And it doesn't matter if you get a little bit in your pan, they easily clean off. Okay, I think I just found my colour. Sometimes it just takes a little bit of playing to see. And I let the picture tell me where I want it to go. I don't really plan it too much at all. I just jump straight in. So I'm not really worrying. And I know that there's shadows on there under the eyes, so I'm going to play that up. So I'd grab a bit of colour and I want a little bit of another colour. I just mix it together like this and it'll blend together on here. It's just been practicing with the tools. You just need to play with them to find out. I didn't really like that one then, so I'm just going to move on to another for this part. Just a flicky, flicky, flick. And I've got quite a lot of pastel on there, so in a minute I'm going to use a pencil eraser just to take a little bit of the pastel out and find my form by cutting back through. You can use the paper in some depth, as I said. So not every bit has to be covered. Liking these two colours together, which would be here and here, or here and here in these tones. So I'm going to play with them, play them up a bit. So even if the colour, as I said, isn't there, we just add a touch of it all around. This white here, because I'm going to just get the depth underneath first before I lay it down. And I'm pushing it into the tooth of the paper. because I know another layer is going to go over the top. So I'm quite heavy handed here. And again, quite thin. Not sure what I'm going to do down here as far as feathering, so I'm just going to get an idea of what's going to go down. Very thin, there's hardly any pastel on there now. So just with any pencil eraser, I'm just going to find the form. So I'm rubbing back in, finding where exactly the eyeball is. This is where I refine all my little movements here. Mark making, finding my shape of the eye. This also lets me know whether everything's in the right spot. And when I'm drawing anything, I'm shutting off my rational side of my brain that tells me I'm drawing an eye. I just want to make sure, I'm just looking at the eyeball as shapes. So I'm seeing it for how it is. The eyeball isn't exactly in the middle. It's up the top here. It's high in the eye. So, and I need to make sure I've got a shadow. Using the blue colours recede and the warm colours come forward. I'm just using quite a bit of blue in the background there, back in there. Just put a little bit of glassine under my hand so I don't drag the pastel around. Just blocking a little bit more depth underneath before I can move on to the light. My map is coming together. And again, even if it's just slightly off, I'm not too worried. It's the patience. The pen pastel allows me to manipulate it as much as I like until I get it. And you can be as free as and fluid as you like, or you can bring it in and heavily detail it. I try and find a bit of personality in, if I'm drawing a subject, a person, animal, bird, and play up on it. Just working in layers. And they seem to take on a life of their own sometimes. I just go along for the ride. Picture, just bringing it all together. This is where it all just starts to make sense for me. And I'm going to put a bit of this highlight in of this blue, this white, but I'm going to use it as a blue so that I can fluff the white over the top. I need to get it down so I can make sure everything's right. Just again, learning the tools. You can use the sharp edge, flat edge, corner, whatever works for you. I'm just finding his fluffy form. And because I've got that depth in there, now when I go in with the highlight, That makes sense. Just using the flat side, just pulling it down. Just getting a sense of his feathery chest. And these marks might not stay in, but they're just giving me an idea of his body. And there's hardly any pan pasta wood at all. It's just all my guide. The charcoal pencil and just find the little edges and make sure I've got everything again in the right spot. I use the pencil to blend the pastel together. If I didn't have that depth in underneath, I wouldn't be able to see the pencil, so. Just making sure I leave that highlight. Now I'm going to use a tiny little bit of a black soft pastel. Just because I want a hard line. And that colour map allowed me to confidently put this down. If I didn't have my map down first, when I used to only work in soft pastels, I would often get things in the wrong spot and I wouldn't be able to move them. I've just got some soft pastels that I'm going to use for just a deeper, more opaque look in some areas. I want my softness of the beautiful pan pastels up here, but I just want a little bit more depth in the eyes, which I could layer up with the pan pastel, but I just want a pop of colour without muddying anything up. So I'm just putting a little bit of that down now. And then I would often come back over the top with the pen pastel tools and soften this all down. And sometimes I use colour to lead the person where the viewer to where I want them to go, which is usually the eyes. So later I will use a touch of this throughout. Try not to blend anything really until later so that none of the colours muddy. Because if you have tones that aren't similar next to one another and you blend too much, it's just going to take the lovely strong colour away. Because I know that an eyeball is round, I always go in the shape again, right from the start to the finish. And I know that his eyes are set quite back in his head, so I just want to get a little bit of depth again. The pen pastel, soft pastel that goes down, I soften it out a little bit with the pen pastel and the tools. Stage, I'm fairly happy with where it is, but I just want a different perspective, so I'm going to turn it upside down and just trick my mind a little to just check that everything is somewhat in the right place, and this allows me to see that I haven't come up far enough with his head, and I'm just going to get some larger tools and start blocking in a bit of background. What I would usually block them in with is the pearlescence. I'd put the pearlescence down first, or a bit of this black, fine black pearl, and it will help me blend in any other colours that I want to blend with over the top. So. And I'll cut a little bit of his ear off because I want the feathers to go over the top later. Again, I need his head to come up a little bit, so I'm leaving room for that. But I like different textures too, so this one is going to be quite blended, and the rest is, I don't mind some choppiness. And then with the pearl mediums, you can mix any other colour, so I'd probably play on some of the blues that I have in the background. And they easily blend it. Once I have that pearl medium down, there's no hard marks with the blue once I lay it down. I'll probably have his head just fading off a bit into the background, no hard lines. Turn it back around. Let's check how it's going. And so now I can softly cut back in a few details. And because we've put our pearl down in our background, we can now start bringing some of the colour down, because I don't like these hard lines. So I'll grab my big tool again. Got my pearl essence. Of the pearls of orange. A little bit more depth under here so that white wasn't coming out enough, so I need the depth in there before I can fluff the feathers out over the top. Just going to perfect the eyes a little bit. Just before I finish up, just coming back in with the pan pastel with the tool that will just allow me to just have a little bit more control. And now's when I just pop out a few colours. So I'm not really blending much, I'm just adding back in the colour. So that it's not muddy or wishy-washy. Up the beak, just getting the form back in. Now I'm being quite particular to clean my sponges so that I'm just getting nice pops of colour. Bluing off the background a bit. Using the point to try and get a sharper edge. Fluffing up the ears a bit. Just so that his head's going to recede a little bit where I put all this blue, and all this warm will come out to the forefront. Little highlights of blue in the eyes, and then the beak. want to play on these feathers here, so I'm just going to add a little bit more depth under here. Trying to work on the picture as a whole, so I'm moving the viewer's eye around with colour. Fluffing or zhuzhing it all up at the end. Just bring those little final touches. Even though my reference isn't straight on and has black in this side, I'm just going to marry each side up. Bit of soft pastel here that now I can confidently make some marks with and pull out the odd hair. I break my pastels into a fine point so that I can get some definition.